Hello friends, welcome to Yogic and Modern Science. Today I am going to take up a very interesting topic, and the topic is the existence of conscious agents and consciousness. You see, just the other day I was studying one article of a contemporary scientist. His name is Donald D. Hoffman. Okay, nowadays he is very popular in this field, and he is trying to explain that the whole creation can be explained, how it came into being and what is the origin of this universe and different types of structures and different types of, you know, things, okay, which are being created, okay, on each moment. So he is explaining that the objective reality around us, okay, is not fundamental. Okay, the bottom line of his article is the objective reality around us is not fundamental. What is fundamental is the consciousness. And this is what he is trying to explain. So, according to Donald D. Hoffman, the consciousness is fundamental, means this is the consciousness due to which the objective reality is taking shape, and objective reality is what we are experiencing, okay, due to the consciousness, right? It means the objective reality is not very substantial. It is, and we have been saying in our episode that this objective reality is not real, it is unreal. Now the same thing is being propagated in other words, in scientific words, by Donald D. Hoffman, and he is trying to say that the objective reality does not exist without the consciousness. Now when he explains the fundamentality of this consciousness, he brings in the concept of conscious agents. According to him, there are multiple conscious agents in this whole prakriti, in this whole universe, right? And these conscious agents, they are more active as compared to other primordial matter in this universe, and since they are more active, they tend to experience something, and according to the set of experiences of these agents, they feel, every conscious agents, okay, they feel different set of space and time. What does it mean? It means the object, the space and time is the construction of these conscious agents. Right, space and time is nothing in itself. It has no basis in itself. It has the basis in conscious agents, or you can say the perception or experiences of all the conscious agents, right, gives rise to the feeling of space and time, okay, or the objective reality, right? So what is space-time? Space-time is nothing but objective reality. Okay, and this objective reality or the feeling of a space-time is proportional to, it is directly proportional to the knowledge of these conscious agents, right? Now friends, you tell me one thing. Did you know these conscious agents, okay, which you are just, you know, listening? I don't think you have ever heard about these conscious agents, but you must know one thing, that we have been talking about the yogic science, and are, you know, in Hindu scriptures, in Jain scriptures, in Buddhism, okay, these have been called by some other names. Like in Hindus, okay, we always talk about jivatmas, right? So in our model, in the model of yogic science, okay, we always talk about multiple jivatmas in the whole prakriti. Now, the conscious agents of Mr. Hoffman is nothing but the multiple jivatmas of yogic science. They are one and the same thing. So in yogic science also, we say that creation happens or it takes place with the help of these jivatmas, right? So this is the experience of these jivatmas due to which the prakriti takes shape according to the experience of the jivatmas, right? And in our system, which is the system of three elements, okay, as you know, the whole system has got three components. Okay, one is the energy of consciousness. I'm not saying consciousness, no, energy of consciousness means pure consciousness, right? And the second component is the prakriti, and third component, within the prakriti there are multiple jivatmas, right? So this is the system of three elements or three principles, right? And we have been saying, explaining about these three principles, okay, since 2 years. And we must understand these conscious agents of or about which Mr. Hoffman is talking about, they are nothing but these multiple jivatmas, right? But the contemporary scientists are missing one point. Okay, they are missing the energy of consciousness, okay, which is around this whole universe or this whole prakriti, okay, and it is very, very dynamic. Okay, I will not say they are running slowly or fast, but they are dynamic in nature, right? But their dynamism is also dynamic, means somewhere, okay, it seems to be very, very fast, okay, and somewhere it seems to be a little slow, right? And they are located, they are found to be located, like sometimes they come directly in contact with the corpuscles or the primordial matter of the prakriti, and somewhere, okay, they are indirectly in touch with them, okay? So somewhere they are direct, somewhere they are indirect. Now, due to the dynamic nature of the energy of consciousness, the primordial matter in the whole prakriti, in the whole in the whole universe, okay, they are all different. Means all the multiple jivatmas, multiple conscious agents are different due to the different type of impact or different, you can say, amount, okay, for the time being, the different amount and different activity of this conscious energy, right, around the primordial matter, right? Now, each and every jivatmas or each and every conscious agents, okay, they are different in their configurations, right? Suppose there are 10 jivatmas over here. Now, all the 10 jivatmas, okay, will have different configuration. They will be different in terms of energy, in terms of, okay, maybe other things, orientation, okay, size, and so on. Now, according to their specificity, they experience a specific thing, right? And according to their experience, okay, the specific type of a space time is created around it, right? Now, in this way, we can say that in this whole universe, okay, there are different types of experiences of time and space because there are different types of conscious agents or different types of jivatmas. Okay, that is why in the Hindu scriptures and in Buddhism also, we always talk about different types of lokas. Okay, different types of, we talk about heaven, hell, we talk about Shivalok, Vishnulok, okay, we talk about, Shakti, right? So many things, right? Now, according to yogic science, okay, these are nothing but the different types of creation according to the different types of these conscious agents or different types of these jivatmas, right? So I just wanted to make you aware about what the contemporary scientists are talking about. Okay, what their contemporary findings are. Okay, so I'm very happy that they have come to this point that there are conscious agents and consciousness is fundamental, okay, to this universe. They are fundamental, not the objective reality, right? Now, one more thing they are talking about, okay, that is these conscious agents or these jivatmas, okay, there is communication between them. And due to the communication between them, okay, different types of material, right, different types of experiences are created, okay, just to adjust or just to just to uphold the experiences of those jivatmas or those conscious agents, right? So what I'm trying to say, what I'm trying to explain is that your universe, okay, your mountains, your plants, your animals, okay, whatever you see as the objective reality around you, okay, it is nothing but your perception, your experience. They are proportional or they are in parallel with your perception, right? If the perception of some other conscious agent is different, for that conscious agent, okay, the experiences will be different. They will have different experiences of the objective reality because objects are not real. What is real is their perception, different perception. Why is the different perception? Because the conscious agents are different. Why are they different? Okay, because of they are being impacted or being influenced differently by the energy of pure consciousness around them, right? So in the next episode, I'll be talking about more, about this universe. Okay, and yes, and we have in the previous episodes also. I have already explained this picture. I have shown you this picture, okay. And in this picture, you can see in this horizontal egg, okay, which I am calling Prakriti. Okay, this is the second component. Okay, and in the second component, you can see the plus sign. All these plus signs, okay, which is being shown, are nothing but conscious agents or jivatmas. Okay, and all the plus are different, okay, in their activity, they are different in their orientation, they are different in their power, okay. That is why they create different experiences, okay, and that is why they create different objective reality, right? So we have been talking about these conscious agents, okay, since the beginning, right? Now some more topic, okay, related to these conscious agents, okay, in the next episode, okay, I'll for sure I'll be talking about this.
Okay, baat karna chahe to phone number.
And I would like to say something to Mr. Donald D. Hoffman and other contemporary scientists and other eager science students, okay, who want to explore into this field, okay. You can talk to me, okay. My phone number is 9908167 81, right? So this is my phone number. I repeat, 9908167 80. This is my phone number. So if any student, science student, or any student who is very interested in spirituality or in understanding this whole cosmos, okay, how things are are being created, they can talk to me on this subject, okay, directly on my phone number, or you can also put down your comment in the comment box. Thank you, friends.